Welkom bij een nieuwe aflevering van ZZ Leiden TV hier in de fraaie studio van Sleutelstad. Ons wekelijkse programma over zorg en zekerheid Leiden basketbal. Ja, die club doet het uitstekend. Evenaarde een record om het seizoen mee te beginnen. 8 keer winnen op rij, dus nog niks verloren. Daarmee ook geplaatst voor de zogenaamde Elite A. En ook al geplaatst voor de play-offs. In de kwartfinale zal Leiden staan. Dat is natuurlijk allemaal later dit seizoen. Die goede start, ja, laatste succes daarin was de winst thuis tegen de nieuwkomer Almere Sailors. Maar liefst 124 tegen 79. En die 124 gescoorde punten, dat was ook een nieuw record voor ZZ Leiden. En ook de 36 assists die de mannen elkaar gaven, een nieuw clubrecord. Leiden gaat verder in de competitie aanstaande donderdag met een uitwedstrijd tegen Heroes in Den Bosch. En dan zondag een uitwedstrijd in Bemmel tegen Joost United. In deze uitzending hebben wij natuurlijk weer de quiz. Weer een mooie vraag met ook een mooie prijs. We hebben deze week ook weer een prachtige studiogast. En ja, daarvoor moeten we ook even terug naar vorig seizoen. Toen natuurlijk opeens de competitie stil kwam te liggen half maart vanwege de corona-uitbraak. En ja, als er dan spelers hun carrière afsluiten of naar een andere club gaan, dan is er geen gelegenheid om feestelijk afscheid te nemen, wat normaal gesproken in een kolkende 5 mei al gebeurt. Maar ja, we hebben natuurlijk wel deze prachtige studio. Dus daarom gaan wij hier ook afscheid nemen van zowel Drago Pasalic, straks op die stoel, en ook binnenkort van Sergio de Randami. We gaan nu eerst naar ons gesprek met Drago. Ja, vandaag is een man aangeschoven die een hele lange en succesvolle basketbalcarrière heeft gehad. Niet alleen bij Donar en bij ZZ Leiden, maar door heel Europa. Hij is al begonnen in 2001 als professional. Dus heeft zo'n beetje 20 jaar op het allerhoogste niveau gespeeld. Is ook international geweest voor zijn land Kroatië. Hij zit hier aan tafel. Welcome, Mr. Drago Pasalic.
Thank you very much.
I will briefly mention all the beautiful countries where you played. You started at a legendary club, Split, in Croatia. Then you went to Turkey, Greece, Spain, Ukraine, Slovenia, Turkey again, Israel, Poland, and you finished your illustrious career in the Netherlands. And you live in Breda.
Yeah, that's correct.
It's also interesting to know. That's correct. Drago, if you don't mind, let's go back to last September when you shocked the basketball world and most of all, of course, yourself and your family. You had a cardiac arrest. How are you doing?
As you can see, I'm doing really good. I'm fully recovered. And yes, as you mentioned, it was a shock for everybody. The biggest, I guess, for my family. Not so much for me, because I don't remember it at all. But yeah, it was. I was really, really lucky in all that what happened. I had a girl called Lara, that she's, I believe, just 23 years old. Wow. That she jumped out of her car and saved my life. And yeah, I was lucky that I was running through the city and I fall down on the floor so somebody could pick me up. But yeah, if I was in the woods,
Ooh, man.
It could be tragic. So I'm very lucky and happy that I'm sitting here today with you.
And you made a full recovery in the meantime.
Yes, I did.
Fantastic.
Yes.
Fantastic. Yes. Does that give you other perspectives on life, on your job, on your family?
Yes. Yes, it took some time, of course, because in the beginning you think, I'm ready to do everything like before. I'm all right, but that's not the case. And it always takes longer time. But of course, when you start to realize what actually happened, that you start to appreciate life better and all little joys what life brings. So, yeah.
You have several children, am I right?
Several. I have 3 children.
Exactly. 3 children. Three boys,
children.
Girls.
I have a boy and girl twins, 10 years old, uh-huh. Ivan and Kinga, and youngest Chiara. She's 8 years old.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Fantastic. Yeah, well, I mentioned it briefly in the introduction for everybody. All of a sudden, there was COVID. There was no more season. More or less, you retired, I could imagine. Maybe, you know, never say never, but after 20 years. How does it feel for you not to be on the court anymore as a professional?
I would say that I overall I accepted all right, but first couple of weeks was really confusing, and even after I made that decision, I was not clear 100% with it. But starting a season with Leiden, I tell to myself and to family that that's going to be probably my last season playing, and I stick with that decision. Of course, it's not the nicest way to end up your career by some virus, yeah. But in the end, I can be grateful that for 20 years I was going strong and reach this career what I did. So,
absolutely. Yeah. Now, it was a shortened season. Any reflections on that? Let's say three quarters of a season with Leiden, things you remember, things that stood out to you?
Yeah, of course. Already playing for Donar, it was always.
You were killing us mostly.
No, but it was awesome just to come in 5 Mile and play a game over there, because the hot atmosphere that you can feel, the vibe, you know, and people so close to the court, and it was always fun, but always fair, I have to say, even then, you know. And then, of course, that when I had to start to play for Leiden, I was excited about that opportunity, how to feel that atmosphere, you know. And they are not cheering against me now, they're cheering for me. So that was really fun. And that season, yeah, we had ups and downs, you know. I have to say that in our European journey, we did pretty all right, you know. And in a competition, you know, there was ups and downs, as I said. Although I think that everybody was looking for that last part of the season, because I was thinking that we were just start growing as a team. And I was expecting our best performance in last couple months of the season.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, we will never know how that could end up. But as I said before, it's to finish the career. Yeah, you want to finish it playing for the trophy.
Exactly.
But yeah, that's you cannot control something. So I'm still happy that I could experience what I experienced in life. Mm-hmm. So
fantastic. Yeah. Talking about that, and I mentioned all the countries where you played, and some beautiful clubs, you know, like Cibona, like Split, PAOK in Greece, the big names. Is there any period of your career that you think there I was at my best or most effective or made the most difference there?
Every of the clubs have a different story. Of course, because of the competition itself, I think Spanish league is very attractive, and I spent three beautiful years there.
You were in Bilbao, a very strong team.
Yes, and we were also playing Europe then, and so you know, atmosphere over there, like playing in front of 15,000 people in some games, that was also spectacular. You know, playing EuroLeague was also for Cibona and for Ulker in Turkey, that was also spectacular. You see all these great facilities, full with people cheering, you know, atmosphere. It's hard to say which period. Also, my starting in Split, that was also, you know, like growing as a player and as a person. So I can't say, okay, this is the best period, but overall I have experiences from some good things, some bad things. Overall, I have no regrets, and I'm enjoying fully in my career. Yeah.
I can imagine that with so many experiences, there's lots that you're very fond of.
Yeah.
So you started in Split. What is the secret of former Yugoslav/Croatian basketball? Why are there so many talented players?
Well, that's
that's. Oh, you don't want to tell us the secret,
no,
maybe?
No, for sure not. It's. It's a little bit, I would say ex-Yugoslavian school. It's pretty famous, not just in Europe, but worldwide. And I think over the years, we kept some good things. And that old school is still working there. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So also natural talent, you know, and a height. It's a key for that sport.
Mm-hmm.
And just the time that we, that people, that kids who are playing basketball, mm-hmm. people who want to succeed in a sport, that they invest over there. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit different than, for example, in Netherlands, of course. I see a lot of potential in Netherlands, if you're talking mm-hmm. about mm-hmm. it as well. This country of tall people as well, you know, mm-hmm. but it's also a country of football and hockey and not yes. as much basketball. I really do hope that can change in the future. We can see great results now from the national team that can,
for sure.
That
for
can
sure.
be an invitation. For
we beat Croatia, you know, maybe not the A team, but still, you know.
Congrats in that way.
Congrats to you too for going
I'm,
to EuroBasket.
I'm happy that was the outcome because I wanted both teams in the EuroBasket and that's happened. Good. So that's good. Yeah. So back to your question. Keep it simple. A lot of hard work and And I think that's the key for everything. So
you mentioned old school. I think discipline is a word there too.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes. Yes. Lot of the discipline if you want to succeed in something, mm-hmm. you know, it doesn't matter is it sport or something else. Mm-hmm. You will invest some extra time in it. That's how I see that kids are growing up over there. So it's not enough to be in a practice and just go home and play mm-hmm. PlayStation. Mm-hmm. No, you take mm-hmm. your ball and go on a playing ground and mm-hmm. practice some more.
For sure.
So that's I think the key, you know.
And there's many playgrounds. I've been there and the weather also helps, you know. So
that's true.
If you want to practice a lot, you can practice a lot.
That's true.
Let's look at the Dutch Basketball League at this moment. You're into a different international career now. We'll talk about that later. Mm-hmm. Do you get time to follow the Dutch league? And if you do anything about ZZ Leiden that you found?
Yeah. Of course, I don't follow it strictly every game, but of course I'm surrounded with the news and once mm-hmm. in a while I see the game and all the compliments to the ZZ Leiden organization and also to coach Geert Hamink, mm-hmm. I think, and the players themselves. I think that everybody is doing a great job mm-hmm. so far, and it's good to see, you know, like, for example, Worthy this year. Mm-hmm. It's, for me, Worthy that I didn't used to. Normally, Worthy okay. would be the player who is, taking a lot of initiative, mm-hmm. a lot of scores, a lot of attractive moves, mm-hmm. but this year Worthy is getting really experienced player, so he's doing a lot of things. He's close mm-hmm. to triple double every single game, and that's interesting to see, you know, that he is giving a great example to the other players that it's not just about a scoring, but it's like, okay, is that steals, block shots, rebounding, assisting, and that's, I think in that way, that's great to see him. Of course, we mentioned before Marijn.
Yeah.
It's for me, it's not a surprise, to be honest, okay. because I saw Marijn's qualities already last year, and he started that step mm-hmm. in the last year, mm-hmm. I believe. And this year, it's great that he got a chance, and then he proved it that he can play on that level, because I could see it every day on the practice what he is capable and how smart he is on the court, so that's fun. And for me, it's not the, I can't say that it's surprise, but Emmanuel Nkwesi, good, his last name. The numbers that he's putting, it's really unbelievable. And I knew it when he signed that what type of player he is, and I was thinking, okay, you know, that is interesting too. Mm-hmm. It's going to be interesting to see how he's going to react, and I think he's doing fine, so more than fine. so overall, I
great,
think
great that you get a chance to still follow it. I recognize a lot of the things you're telling us.
So in that, but Dutch league in this way, just to finish it, I think it's going to be really interesting this year. Okay, Donar and Leiden and Den Bosch, of course, I think that's going to be a real fight. To not forget
Zwolle,
it's there always. But, you know, like, I think still that once in a while there's going to be some surprises from smaller teams, let me call them that way. Then Helder almost took one in Groningen the other night. So I think it's going to be interesting, especially towards the end, cup competition and the playoffs. So it's going to be a lot of fun to watch. Yeah.
Drago, you're wearing a fantastic sweater of the LA Clippers. Can you talk about your, maybe it's not a new career, because I think you were working for them already, but what is your role within the organization?
No, so I'm now a consultant scout, international scout. That's the call of the job. And I'm following professional basketball player, so I'm not watching the younger guys. That's not my job right now. So just guys who are above 22 years old who cannot go in the NBA draft no more. So I'm following them and seeing if, you know, there was some guy who were missed to pick on the NBA draft and who could build up his career in Europe and maybe find his path to go in NBA again. So
would that include the G League maybe as well, or is it?
Sorry.
Would that include maybe then first going to the G League, or?
That's also a possibility. Yes, okay. Or for summer league as well, and it's. So yeah, as I'm saying, I'm still new in this job. I'm learning a lot every day. The fun part is of course traveling and seeing the games in the live, talking to the people about some players. But I hope that's going to come, like audience going back to everybody's waiting for that moment. So yeah,
it's now a lot of virtual meetings, a lot of Zoom calls and stuff like that.
Yes. And it's, you know, in a way, like people are making their offices from their home. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I had to do the same thing. So it's not the same, but it's still okay, you know, and it's, I like the job itself, and I hope that I can still grow in it. So,
are you focusing on the European region, or is it truly global?
When we say international, then it's global except United States. Mm. But of course, mainly it's Europe, because I would say after NBA, the most quality basketball is in Europe.
So, Would this be something, the whole scouting direction that you have taken, to keep developing in your career, or maybe you see other functions, jobs within basketball
it's not exactly scouting. I was looking, when I was finishing my career, I was looking the way of staying to live in the Netherlands and being still active in the basketball. Mm-hmm. Honestly talking, there's no many possibilities and not many jobs that you can make as a full-timer in the Dutch basketball at the moment. Hopefully that's going to change. But, you know, it was a lot of moving around, as you saw it in how many countries I played. So it was a lot of moving for my family, and I decided together with my wife, okay, it's time to settle down. So we want to live in the Netherlands, and that I'm still active in the basketball. And this was the perfect way. For now, for sure. And later on, who knows? You know, that's it's important to stay in a world of basketball, to be active, to be, you know, but what's gonna bring tomorrow, I can't tell you.
Well, it's fantastic that you have this position now to be involved, as you say.
I think so too.
Fantastic. Drago, we would like to finish. We have a personal camera for you, if you don't mind. You can take a minute, just think about something. We always say to our guests, you know, there's a lot of people watching this TV show. They're all behind this camera. Yeah. You are in their hearts. Is there anything you would like to say to the Leiden basketball community? And if so, take a moment and take the lens, if you don't mind, and talk to them.
Hello, everybody. I'm so glad that I'm here, having the opportunity to say at least hello and thank you for everything you did for me. I cannot forget when I was in the hospital, how many letters, flowers, fruits, nice packages you sent it to me to wish me good recovery. Mm-hmm. And I'm really thankful for that. It means really a lot to me. So I'm sending you all the best regards in this way. Hopefully soon we're gonna see each other in a live. But stay healthy and enjoy every moment of your lives. And I hope I see you soon.
That was beautiful. Thank you so much. Dragan Pašalić, thank you so much for being part of the Leiden family. And lots of success. Both with your career, but also, like you said, a lot of health, a lot of love for your family.
Thank you for
your invitation. We hope to see you many times again.
Thank you for the invitation. It was a pleasure to be here. All the best.
Well, Drago, maybe you have noticed that ZZ Leiden is also a club of many traditions. And one of them, if a favorite, well-beloved player leaves the club, we want to say goodbye in front of all the fans in the center of the court and have a last hooray for this player. But unfortunately, as you know, with COVID, we are without fans in the arena. But still, we have found, I think, a very nice way to say goodbye to you officially on behalf of the club. And for that, Marcel Verburg, our president, will now take my place.
Yeah, normally, Drago, we say goodbye in, let's say, the audience of the 5 Mei Hall. But without fans, there's nothing. Yeah, there is a game, but that's nothing. So we decided to do it over here. And we are glad that you're here. Yeah, you only played 1 year for Leiden. And I think that was too short. That should have been more years. But yeah, things go like they go. And you make progress and for the LA Clippers. So that's also good for you. And I hope also for Dutch basketball. And I hope you stay in the Netherlands as well, because we can make use of your intense and real rich career and knowledge about basketball. And maybe we can do that in Leiden in the future as well, Drago. Who knows? Yeah, we want to say goodbye, but we don't want to say it without nothing. So we made a picture for you. And we also have some flowers for you. And what I say, I think 1 year was too short. But in that year, and that is also important for our young players, a player like you with such a rich career that helps our young players. Marijn is doing well and he is doing great, I think. And I think it's because of players like you who can develop them and make them grow. So again, I hope you will stay in the Netherlands and maybe can do also something great for Leiden, and wish you all the best in your future.
Well, Marcel, thanks a lot for this beautiful gesture. I'm really honored to be invited here, and that you think of me after my career. As you mentioned, that 1 year was too short. I wish that I could finish that season with Leiden and give some joy to all the fans of Leiden. But I'll stay living in the Netherlands, and I hope that I can be in use and help not just to Leiden, but also to the Dutch basketball in general. So we'll keep in touch. We'll be close to each other in the future for sure.
Absolutely. It was a pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Het laatste onderwerp van deze uitzending is de quiz. En hier op tafel ligt de nieuwe prijs voor de quiz. Deze prijs is alleen te winnen, niet te koop. Het is een echt exclusieve bal van Zorg en Zekerheid. In de kleuren van de club, met ook nog eens de handtekeningen van alle spelers erop. Vanaf nu is die prijs elke week te winnen, plus een voucher om gratis naar de livestream te kijken. En de gelukkige deze week is Roy van Gerven. En hij gaf zoveel mogelijk goede antwoorden op de vraag: welke spelers waren international voor hun land in de periode dat ze bij Leiden speelden, of rond die tijd, even los van de Oranje Internationals. En Roy kwam onder andere met de namen Javon Shepherd voor het nationale team van Canada, Alexander Ola, nationale team van Roemenië, en Connor Grace, u kent hem nog, uit Ierland. En dan, als je het helemaal perfect wil doen, dan kun je ook nog aan mensen denken als Drago Pašalić, ooit voor Kroatië, maar dat was wel langer geleden voordat hij bij Leiden zat. Sergio de Randami, Suriname. Maar ook David Chiotti, die na Leiden Italiaans burger werd en voor Italië speelde. En tegenwoordig ook Nuni Omot, die nu in Turkije speelt. Hij speelt voor zijn land Zuid-Soedan. Roy, enorm gefeliciteerd. En wij gaan naar de vraag van deze week. En die luidt. Het hoofdkantoor van de hoofdsponsor Zorg en Zekerheid heeft aan de gevel een enorme afbeelding van een heel populaire leiderspeler. Wat is zijn naam? U kunt het antwoord mailen naar zzleidentv@gmail.com. En dus niet alleen kans op een voucher, maar ook op zo'n prachtige basketbal. We zijn aan het einde gekomen van deze uitzending, maar niet getreurd. Alles over ZZ Leiden is natuurlijk altijd 24 uur per dag te volgen via de website zzleiden.nl. En ook volgende week zijn we er weer met ZZ Leiden TV. Bedankt voor het kijken.